مايك تشيك 1 2.
حبي للهيب هوب مش شيء غريب، انا عجبني عشان حته حرية التعبير، انت بتعبر عن رايك. والهيب هوب مش دخيل علينا زي ما كل حد بيفاكر، يعني اللي هو الحاجه من الغرب. هو الهيب هوب ابتدى فعلا في امريكا، في نيويورك بالتحديد، بس هو مش غريب علينا في مجتمعنا الشرقي والعربي والمصري. انا بالنسبه لي صلاح جاهين الشاعر العظيم كان بيكتب هيب هوب، يعني الشعر بتاعه الشعر العامي ده انا بعتبره هيب هوب. لو قريت كلام صلاح جاهين على ايقاع هو هيب هوب. ثلاثي اضواء المسرح لما كان يقول لك بص لي حته دي مبصه ورقعني الم وتوسط، ده ما هيب هوب على ايقاع برضو. شريهان في الفوازير بتاعتها لما كانت بتعمل اللي هي الاستعراضات والكلام اللي هو الاستعراضي ده بالنسبه لي هيب هوب. فعشان كده المجتمع العربي والمصري بالتحديد يعني كلهم لما سمعوا المزيكا دي ما كانتش غريبه عليهم، حبوها، دخلت قلبهم.
I fell in love with hip hop, man, because it just spoke to me. I was an Arab immigrant kid growing up here in America, and I felt drawn to it for so many different reasons. I mean, it was raw, it was lyrical, it spoke to my culture as a Muslim, since so many of the artists who I listened to growing up were Muslim. And it also, you know, gave me an opportunity to show people what I loved about my culture, the poetry and the storytelling, and it gave people a chance to kind of be exposed to it in this unique way. And so it's something that, you know, I'm really grateful for being able to kind of rep in this way. And I think it's important for young people in the Middle East to also know the roots and the history of hip hop. And so I consider myself a bridge builder in many ways. And I'm just trying to remind folks both here of the beauty of our culture and young people back in the Middle East about what experiences are here in America. So that's why I love hip hop, man. Shout outs to Narsi, highly intellectualized people hovering over politics.
كلامي في الأغنية دي نوع من الدعم المعنوي والدعم الإيجابي لأي مبدع عايز يطلع طاقته. بخاطب كل حد، بخاطب الكتاب، بخاطب الفنانين، الرسامين، أي حد عايز يقول حاجة ويفيد مجتمعه.
So the lyrics to my verse on the Anghami Cypher track, I think are just indicative of my career as a rapper with roots in the Middle East, living here in America my whole life. I shout out Hama, which is where my father is from in Syria. I shout out Damascus, which is where my mother is from. I do a lot of back and forth between Arabic and English, which I think is a representative of my experience here in the diaspora. And also the kind of coding that I like to do with this rap music, you know, my experience as lived through this medium of rap is something that, you know, I've grown to love to be able to express myself through, so it's a big part of me. Also shout out Big Haas, who's been a huge supporter of hip hop music in the Arab world for the last many years. And I also just remind people that I'm an independent artist, and I've been an independent artist for over a decade. This is something I'm really proud of, and I hope that other young rappers in the Arab world understand that, you know, it's important to have aspirations as an artist, you know, maybe want to succeed in various ways, but that success shouldn't hinge on whether or not you get signed or you make a certain amount of money. You have to do this for yourself. You have to do this because you love it and you love to express yourself and you love to put, you know, your voice out there in a way that is meaningful. And so that's something that I try to remind people of.
هي شوف من ناحيه الاشتراكات يعني اكثر من فنان مع بعض، الشيء هذا مهم للفنانين ومهم للحركه اللي هي حركه الثقافه نفسها، مهم للفنانين من ناحيه انه انت بتعرض اعمالك وبتعرض صوتك وصوتك بيوصل لناس ما كانوا يسمعوك لانهم بيسمعوا الفلان هذا، وهذا الشيء بغض النظر عن عدد المتابعين وعدد الجمهور، لانه احنا كفنانين نحترم القيمه الفنيه لبعض. فكذا مهمه للفنانين، مهمه للثقافه انها بتوحد المشاهد مع بعض. يعني فلان آدم عنده مشهد خاص بي بيقدم فنه للناس جماهير مختلفة، أنا بقدم فن لجماهير مختلفة، فالشيء ده بيجتمع يوحد الحركة، تكون الحركة مستمرة على جهة واحدة بس وتمشي.
I think tracks like these are really important for hip-hop culture because they remind listeners of the fact that it's this global, universal culture that's hit all corners of the globe. And you know, when it comes to hip-hop in the Middle East and North Africa, not only is it something new, but it's also something that's carrying the traditions of poetry that have existed there for thousands of years.